Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around LoRaWAN and PyPI. PyPI is an ESP32 based development board that can be programmed using MicroPython and it is developed by PyCom. The module comes with 5 different network protocol supports which include CAT-M1, NB-IoT, Sigfox, LoRa and the usual Wi-Fi and Bluetooth that comes by default with the ESP32. Controller. In this video, we will be connecting a DHT12 humidity and temperature sensor which comes with an ITSO interface to the PyPI module, and we will be sending the data to the Things Network server using LoRaWAN. After that, the processed data from TTN will be sent to ThingSpeak where it will be shown in charts. However, to make it work, you need to have an LoRa gateway around and should be connected to TTN. If you want to add your own LoRaWAN gateway, you can check out my earlier videos on this, for which I have provided the links down below in the description. And make sure you are using the proper frequency band for LoRaWAN, which is as per your local regulations. Like for me, it is 865 to 867 MHz in India. So over here, we'll have different stages of data flow that includes like from the DHT12 sensor to the PyPI board, which involves I2C interface, wherein we'll be just reading data from the DHT12 registers to the module. We'll be sending the data through LoRa protocol using the 865-867 MHz frequency band to the TTN server, and that will be sent through a TTN gateway, which again communicates the data or acts as a gateway from LoRa to the TTN server. And the gateway sends data using UDP, MQTT or WebSocket or gRPC communication protocol. So this actually depends on the packet forwarder that is being used by the gateway. And again, if you are sending data and if you have multiple gateways around, it will be received by all the gateways and will be sent to the TTN network. After that, we'll process the received data in TTN server and will forward the same using the integrations provided by TTN to ThingSpeak, where it will be shown in charts. So let's see how to do that. And being said that, let's get started, guys. So guys, to start with this, we'll first make the required connections. And the one that we are doing is connecting the DHT12 sensor with the PyPI module. And as the sensor comes with I2C interface, the connection is pretty much straightforward. The SDA pin of the sensor goes to the SDA pin of PyPI and the SCL pin goes to the SCL pin. And both the lines are pulled up by 4.7 kilo-ohm resistors to 3.3 volt. Over here, the 3.3 volt comes from the 3.3 volt output of the PyPI module. And ground of the sensor goes to the ground pin of the module. Along with that, we also need one USB to UART converter, as PyPI board doesn't feature any onboard USB to UART converter. And to access the REPL console and as well as upload scripts to it, we need some sort of communication between our PC and the PyPI module. So over here, we are using USB to UART module, but you can certainly use Telnet or FTP to do file transfers and all. So the connection between the USB UART module and the PyPI module is pretty much straightforward. The TX goes to RX of the module and the RX of the converter goes to the TX of the PyPI board. Apart from that, we just need to connect the 5 volt output of the USB to UART converter to the PyPI board to supply the required power to the board. Again, don't use the 3.3 volt output of the USB to UART converter to power up your PyPI board module, as the minimum voltage required for PyPI is more than 3.5 volt. Again, the ground pin goes to the ground pin of the module. So that's all with the hardware connections, guys, and it is pretty much straightforward. So guys, after the required connections are made and the sensor is connected to the PyPI module, we'll go ahead and register our application in TTN console. Again, over here we are using the Things Network as our network server for LoRa. So over here, get into the console of the Things Network. And again, you need to have an account for that. So get into applications, add one application. So I'll just name it PyPI test. I'll just put a test application as description. Yep, then I'll just on another one. Okay, we are done with the application registration. So I'll just go ahead and add my device. So over here, I'll change the activation method. And as you know, if you are aware of LoRaWAN and all, it supports OTA as well as ABP. So I'll go ahead with ABP method. So I'll just save it. And this actually, as we are using ABP, these are the keys that we need in our MicroPython script. So that's pretty much all about registering the application, guys. And we'll revisit this particular page after we are done with our scripts and all, and we are able to send data. So let's go ahead and check the MicroPython scripts that we are using with the PyPI module. So over here, I have set up the VS Code add-on for my, you know, PyPI module and all, and that is pretty much simple. And if you are new to this and you want to set it up, you can check out my other video around it, which is linked down below in the description. So after setting up the VS Code and all, you'll be able to access your PyPI module from the terminal of the VS Code over here. So that appears as PyMaker console. This also opens up the REPL console from the module or the PyPI board over here. So let's go through the script that I'm using. Actually, if you're working with MicroPython, there are two files that is, you know, run by default as the, you know, module boots and all. First one is the boot.py. And second one is the main.py. So each time the, you know, module boots up, this particular files are run by default. So I haven't written nothing in boot.py, but again, you can write if you want certain functionalities to whenever the module boots up. So let's go to the script that I'm using. So over here, simple imports and all, then I'm using pycom.heartbeat false. So this will disable the by default blinking of the LED, which excites as heartbeat of the PyPI module. So that's nothing there. Then I am just creating a LoRa object with LoRa.LoRaWAN. So I'm making the mode as LoRaWAN mode. After that, I am setting up the region, and for me it is IN865. So for you, if you are in different country and all, it will change accordingly. After that, I am setting up device classes, class A. As you know, LoRaWAN supports three classes, class A, class B and class C. The PyPI module stack supports class A and class C. So over here you can make class A or class C, but I have gone with class A. And if you know in detail about the different modes and all, or different classes, you can check out the link in the description down below. After that, I have just created one I2C object that I'll be using to interact with the DHT12 sensor connected to the module. After that, we are just reading from the NVRAM NVRAM of the module if there are anything related to the LoRa network. So this API is provided by the LoRa stack of the PyCom module or the PyPI module over here. And if you have already connected to the network earlier, so if the session keys and all are available, you can read read it from the NVRAM storage. So for that, you need to first save. So at the end of script, I have this command over here, or this function I have, this method I'm calling, NVRAM save, which saves the session data. So if you are booting for the first time, very first time, it won't be available. But yeah, in subsequent boots, whenever you are using deep sleep and all, it will face the required data and all. After that, I'm just checking if LoRa had joined the network or LoRaWAN network or not. If not, I'm just creating some keys and all. After that, I'm using the LoRa.join method to join the LoRaWAN network. And over here, as I said earlier, I'm using ABP method, and as well as I'm passing the authentication keys and all. So these keys can be obtained from this device registration. So as I said earlier, these are the keys that we need. So I'll just go over down below and I'll copy the device address. And you can see device address is this one. Then after that, I need the network session key. So I'll just paste it over here. Then I need the F session key. Yep. So these three keys are required as far as ABP method is concerned. So as we are using AP method, this three keys will do first, and I'll just to provide with the join method. Again, after that, we just getting into while loop and we're checking if it has joined the LoRaWAN WAN network or not. Till then, it will make the LED red. And this actually, the LoRa.join internally tries after every 15 seconds till it joins the network. So this while loop will continue till then after every 2.5 second delay. After that, we are just making the LED green, showcasing that okay, we have successfully connected to the LoRaWAN network or joined the network. So if you know you have already had a sessions and all, so this particular piece of code not execute, it will come directly over here because you might have already joined true and all. After that, we are creating a LoRa socket, say raw socket and all. After that, we are setting up the data rate for the socket. And if you want to set particular LoRa centric value, values and all, like the spreading factor, the bandwidth, the etc., you can use the respective APIs. So I'll put the link to the documentations down below in the description. After that, we are making the LoRa socket as blocking because we want to make sure data is getting got transferred and all. And this will wait till data is sent and the two receive windows expire because we are using class A. After that, we are reading data directly from the sensor. Data to write to CD, read from MEM, and 0x5C is the address of the DHT12 module. And we are reading from 0x00 register, and we are reading 5 bytes out of it. After that, I am just sending out the red data or the red array directly using LoRa socket.send. After that, we are just making the set blocking as false and we are closing the LoRa socket. Now, if you want to read the data, if you are receiving anything from the TTN server and all, you can use data equals LoRa socket.receive and the number of bytes you are looking for. But over here, I am not using that because I don't need that for time being. After that, we are just making the heartbeat as true. Again, the LED will start blinking. And I'm just adding a 10 second delay because after that I'm just getting into disk sleep mode. And let's say if you want to change the scripts and all, and if what happens is you have reset your boot, this code will particularly finish pretty quickly. So again, it will go to disk sleep mode pretty quick. So if you want to change anything in the scripts and you want to upload new files and all, this won't be possible because the module already will be in disk sleep mode. So to enable that, to make sure that we can communicate with the device within 10 seconds of the, it comes out of deep sleep mode and all. That's why I have just provided the 10 second delay. So within this time, 10 second time, we can change the scripts and all. You can re-upload the scripts if it is required. After that, we are just saving the session to NVRAM by invoking the LoRa.NVRAM save method. After that, it enters into the deep sleep mode. So guys, that's all about the script. This what it is doing is it is coming out of the deep sleep mode. It is sending out the data right from the sensor using LoRa, and after that it is again going into deep sleep mode. So every 15 minutes it will come out of the deep sleep mode, send the data, again it will get into the deep sleep mode. So now if you want to upload these files or if you have changed anything and all and you want to upload, you can simply hit the upload button over here in the VS Code. And I'll just reset my module over here. Yes, now files are uploaded and I should be able to see my data in the TTN console. So if I go to my device and you can see over here, it has received data 19 seconds ago. So yeah, you can see two payloads over here available, and you can see 5 bytes of data over here payloads. So these are the raw data read from the sensor. I have not passed in the module, wherein I'll pass the data in the TTN server only. So guys, we are getting our data over here, and now we need to pass the payload and send the data, or over here the temperature and humidity data, to ThingSpeak. So to do that, we need to first create the required channel in Thingspeak. So over here in thingspeak.com, I'll just get into channels. And again, you need to have an account over here. Then create new channel. And I'll just type in TTN integration. No description. Field one is temperature. After that, I'm just getting into API keys section over here, and we need this write API key in TTN. So what we'll do is next get into the TTN console, and over here you'll see something like integrations. Again, you need to be in the app. So if you are in device level, it won't be there. So click on integration and click on Thingspeak. So I'll just put a process ID. Authorization is the channel write API key, and which is this one. And channel ID is, I'll just put PyPy and add integration. So this will send the received data from TTN to the Thingspeak channel. There are different APIs available for Thingspeak. You can pretty much go through that if you want to manually call or invoke the APIs. Now over here, get into private views. We don't have any data yet. And after that, we just need to format the payload that we are receiving and send it to, you know, like make it in a way such that it can be parsed by Thingspeak. And the way we are going to do is we need to create an object with field one and field two as, you know, keys or the JSON keys over here, so that Thingspeak can, I know, parse that out. So to do that, we need to write on. So the decoder function has got bytes and port, wherein bytes is the incoming data bytes and port is the port that you know, a port and all value and all. So I'll not be using port particularly, but yeah, if you want to, you know, have multiple devices and you want to separate each device, you can set the port in your you know, MicroPython script, and you can check for particular port and you can pass the data accordingly over here. So I'll just do one thing. I'll just paste the script over here. What I'm doing is I'm getting the bytes data, which is 5 bytes actually, and I'm calculating the or checking the checksum, which is nothing but the sum of 0, 1, 2, and 3 bytes. It should be equal to the 4th byte. After that, I'm just calculating humidity, then the scaling value for temperature, the sign of temperature, it can be negative and positive, that's why the MSB defines the sign. After that, I'm just you know, setting up the decoded object field one key as temperature and field two as humidity. After that, it just returns the decoded value. So if the checksum is not equal, it won't return anything, it will just return a null on this object null. So after that, I just need to save payload functions. Oh, sorry, actually, I just made a mistake over here. The channel ID is the channel ID over here. So, yep. Should be. Now we should have the data in Thingspeak as well. And yeah, you can see over here the data has come. That's pretty much all about it, guys, and I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button, and if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, consider subscribing it, and see you next time with our next video. Till then, goodbye.